This meeting to order and declare open the sixth session of the Ministerial Conference of the WTO.
N'oublions pas que l'OMC est un système.
世界貿易組織 WTO 1995年成立，前身是關稅及貿易總協定，鼓勵各國擴大經濟活動，促进国与国之间的贸易。十年来，世贸成员有增无减，而家有150个会员国，会员每两年举行一次的部长级会议，就贸易协定进行谈判。
Trade is for the capitalist, not for the suffering people.
Women resist WTO. No! WTO! Trade under the World Trade Organization is never fair. It is only biased for the first world countries, and it eats out the resources of third world countries.
在世贸百几个成员国当中，三分二是发展中国家，其中32个更加是属于低度发展的国家。第六次世贸部长级会议在香港举行，有6000个代表参加。今次会议推动多哈发展回合议程，不过如果在农产品补贴和关税问题上没有办法取得突破性的发展，其他的议题包括金融服务、电信开放等谈判都会遇到阻碍。
I would say that I'm a realist. We cannot abolish the WTO at this time, but we can begin the process of reversing the powers of the WTO so that we create a momentum.Towards weakening and weakening it, and expanding and expanding the maneuverability or the ability of countries to be able to determine their own paths of economic development and not be imprisoned by WTO rules.
Democracy now. Gordon Bellow, 专注政策研究的民间组织 Focus on the Global South 总监。他反对成立世贸组织，认为现在世贸所推行的自由贸易以商业财团利益为主导，削弱贫穷国家的自主和发展。
You look at the key agreements of the WTO, they promote monopoly. They promote monopolistic control by a few over production and markets. Two in particular, the agreement on agriculture.The agreement on agriculture is not about free trade. The agreement on agriculture is about legitimizing the high degrees of subsidization of European Union and US agriculture. So if people come and say the WTO promotes free markets, I laugh because this is really an institution that promotes monopolistic control by large corporations.
我谂香港唔可以一定系咁一个自私，就系觉得香港一个贸易城市，唔去考虑到呢个贸易，其实你系贸易紧嗰啲系一啲劳工所做出嚟嘅产品，系一啲农民所做出嚟嘅产品。今次呢一个嘅会议系一个很好嘅一个窗口，啊，去打破呢一种咁样嘅我哋嘅无知，或者系去拒绝去认知呢啲咁样嘅现实，而去更加深入去了解到，其实我哋香港人咧系对于呢啲农民嘅工人嘅处境咧，我哋系。有一定的责任。
陆德全今年开了一个有关世贸的课程，鼓励学生参与反世贸运动，了解示威人士怎样坚持争取社会公义。
3点开波在唐街那边出，
是啊 ，OK。
等等，
自由，
到边啊？到
边啊？可能香港市民比较多，净系有留意南韩啦，啊。因為好似佢哋用嘅肢體嗰個係比較上激烈啲，但其實我哋留意到響而家，譬如話好似孟加拉嘅工人啦，仲有一啲農民響自由貿易協議底下所遭受到衝擊，就係啲種甘蔗嘅農民啦，種棉花嘅農民啦，但佢哋唔可能建立得個聯繫，佢哋而家種生活嘅遭遇係呢個世貿協議所造成，咁所以可以講係有時係死咗都唔知咩事。
在发展中国家，大部分人口以农业为生，好似菲律宾本来是农产品输出国，1995年加入世贸被迫开放市场之后，稻米和粟米入口量激增5倍，农产品价格急剧下跌，2600万农户生计受到威胁。
Save our rice, junk WTO!
Save our rice, junk WTO!
They dump cabbages, the Cordillera farmers in Cordillera region. They sell only 1 peso per kilo of cabbage. So, because the imported cabbage, the other one, the locally produced, are 8 pesos per kilo.
Junk WTO!
Junk WTO!
The farmers now, in our case studies, yeah, more than 15 pesos they earn a day. But in the Philippines, living in the rural areas, according to government data, we need almost 400 pesos daily income for a family of 6. So that's why I'm saying that living in the Philippines,especially in the rural areas, is misery.
其实而家系对嗰个粮食市场威胁啦，响而家现有，特别系美国同埋欧盟嘅一个倾销底下咧，所以变咗佢哋好廉价咁样嘅吓，即系向国际市场供应啦。嗱，听起嚟咧就好似系发展国家买咗平嘅一啲粮食。但关键是当啲粮食是平的时候呢，其实它是破坏了当地的生产粮食的积极性，粮食的供应呢就会是依赖了外面。那譬如好像上次这个印尼那个亚洲金融危机的时候，它的货币贬值，即是它要用很高的外汇才能买得到粮食。
在韩国农产品市场开放，入口的农产品不断增加，本地生产就自然减少，很多农民唯有放弃耕种。在韩国加入了世贸，鼓吹自由贸易，其实只是对跨国企业有利，大公司好像 Samsung、 LG 那就赚钱，小市民好像我们那样就无份。
The WTO was created to enforce rules of trade, not free trade. But short term and long term, it appears that a large number of people are harmed and permanently harmed. So I think the ideology of free trade is rhetoric. I believe that the fair trade movement rules of trade that ensure fair prices for producers will be a much better system than deregulated or unregulated trade. That kind of unregulated trade or free trade appears to harm many more people than the small number already wealthy who would benefit from free trade.
In the world. Our total this year was $1.34 billion. Markets by reducing.
为期六日喺香港举行嘅世贸部长级会议，今日系最后一日。世贸150个会员国之中，发达国家占咗1/3，其余嘅都系发展中国家，以农业为主要经济命脉。而今次部长级会议，农业补贴、开放市场系重要嘅议题。不过，各国仍然未能够达成一致的协议。世贸成员国本来就贫富悬殊，在谈判桌上，强国一方面要求其他地方开放市场，但是自己就拒绝在补贴议题上作出让步，令穷国和发达国家距离越来越远。
Subsidies, while part of the answer, certainly is not the whole answer.Part of the answer to that is market access. Part of the answer is to enable the West African cotton producers to have better, more open markets, not just in the developed world where they have good access right now, but in fact in other countries, that are big consumers of cotton.
美国政府每年对出口棉花作出高达$3 billion的补贴。非洲国家占这些补贴，令市场上棉花价格大跌。洛斯会发表的报告，只由2001至2003年，美国倾销大量棉花，导致非洲产棉国损失高达$400 billion。
This is a matter that affects millions of lives. It affects human rights. It affects our sheer survival.
The U.S. has made a new offer to increase African cotton exports into the U.S. market, but that's not really appropriate because over the last 4 years, African cotton producers have exported 0 gram of cotton to the U.S. The main problem is really with the subsidies, which have an impact on world prices of cotton, and that's what a real issue for the West Africans.
会议期间，在农产品补贴和关税问题上的谈判还未有突破之前，美国、欧盟和日本这些经济强国纷纷宣布在未来几年对发展中国家增加数以十亿元的贸易援助。
As parliamentarians, we do not agree with aid for trade because conventional aid has not solved anything in Africa. A number of times we've seen that more resources, when we are given aid as in Africa, as a developing country, more resources are taken out of our economy and it's not solving our problems. Instead, our people are becoming poorer and poorer. And the package on the table right now, which is saying aid for trade, we feel aid discussions have no place in WTO.WTO is meant to discuss trade. Let us limit it to trade.
It's not only a distraction and a diversion, though. It's actually even worse than that, because from the European perspective, at least, it's based on a package of lies the European Union cannot possibly guarantee to provide. And at a time when we know very well that the British presidency, among others, are actually talking about slashing European budgets.Now, if we're talking about major cuts to European budgets, the idea that somehow this €1 billion is going to be found is a fantasy land.
If you look at the majority of the studies on the current deal, the developed countries or the richer countries would actually be better off by 83% of the entire gains. Developing countries, if you scaled it to on a per person basis, would get less than a penny per day per person in the year 2015.Which is why many of the developing countries that are here today are a little skeptical of the deal that's on the table.
今次世贸会议其中一个重要议题是灭贫。不过根据世界银行的统计，全球穷困人口在1997年大约有8亿3千万，到2002年反而增加了2600万人，显示自由贸易 并不可以有效解决贫穷问题。在世贸会议期间，200多个来自东南亚的移民出海抗议，要求世贸停止谈判渔业问题。因为先进国家除了过度捕猎，又补贴渔产品，轻易打入他们的市场，以致收入大减。
渔民根本没有能力养起头家，他们的家人、老婆和仔女唯有去其他有钱的国家打工，送仔女读书，应付基本生活需要。他们每个月只赚到3000披索，一日100披索都没有。
Fishery subsidies, the bulk of which are provided by developed economies, have an adverse impact on the productivity, trade competitiveness, and fishery conservation efforts of developing countries. Subsidies provided by a handful of developed countries prostrate the ability of developing countries to move towards sustainable fishery development.
Defend the fishing ground! The fishery is for sale!
Pagkat yung mga...
世贸组织的政策没有照顾到渔民的利益。自由贸易，世贸希望取消所有障碍。大部分发展中国家给好高补贴他们的捕鱼业。菲律宾政府对渔民没有任何补贴。
There have been many agreements.Signed between the Philippine government and many other governments with big economies, larger economies, through this WTO and liberalization process. And many of these agreements not only violated their provisions, but they more so were not in favor of the general public as a whole.
内地民工冯兴忠、杨仁平患上直肺病，失去工作能力，趁着世贸会议专程来参加游行，向香港老板索偿。世贸鼓吹自由贸易、资本流通，企业到发展中国家投资，无疑可以扩大利润，但是工人的利益就没有得到重视。
我身体是很累，但是我心里感到很舒服，因为能够把我们的烟富裕出去，让全世界的市民都知道，我们比这些厂家、比这些老板伤害了。
来到香港，他们得到世界各地工会代表支持，去争取自己的权益。
这是我们来就是为了讨回自己的权益。
工会最凶啊！
拿职位上，
年轻为上。
还有他的品牌，他卖出去的就是说打出的品牌。发达国家就是说，因为大陆改革开放引外资，降低成本，不顾工人的就是说权益，安全也得不到保障。
WTO 也把资本主义的内在矛盾推向了全世界。特别表现在发展中国家，工人的劳动条件极端恶劣，经济发展在相当程度上是以劳工利益的牺牲为代价获得的。
是我们现在要在争取啊，大家团结起来。我也知道，在整个亚洲都是这些工人都是一样的。今天就是说看到这么多人游行过来，就是说抗议这个世贸，但是我们在内地的话没有这个机会，所以说很多赶到这里来呼吁，就是说这个世贸的危害，就是说对农民这些，或者是对我们的工商者的危害。但是我也不就是说不清楚他们在里面开会能不能听到我们的呼声。
The WTO is bad for the world. No WTO.
No, no WTO.
Warden Bellow 除了身体力行参与反世贸活动，还是学者，致力推动国际公义。他说他赞成国与国进行贸易，不过 对建基于不公平合作基础的所谓自由贸易就强烈反对。
I don't mean that we should withdraw from the international economy. I mean, it would be foolish to do that. What we want to do is to change the basis of relationships among countries in the international economy, so that we do not interact on the basis of corporate-driven profitability, but we want to interact on the basis of equality. We are trying to construct a world in which the interests of people are ahead of the interests of corporations. We want to construct a world in which countries can develop following development strategies of their choice instead of their development being subordinated to free trade and to the interests of corporations.
世界贸易组织第六次部长级会议快将结束。